Hello children, welcome to today's class. In my previous class I have solved questions of exercise 8.1 up to 4th question. Now 5th question, it is just the converse of the statement of the square that in a quadrilateral if the diagonals are equal and bisect each other at right angles, you should prove it as an square. That is your next question. In order to prove this quadrilateral as an square, I have taken my quadrilateral as A, B, C, D. They have given the diagonals AC and BD gets bisected at O at right angle they have given. Here only one proof if you do, it is more than enough children. You have to prove any one of the angle as 90 degree. That is either ADC, BCD, DAB or CBA. Any one of the angle if you prove as 90 degree, then you can directly show this quadrilateral as a square. So what are given, that I am going to write first children. AC and BD are getting intersected at O, it is known fact, and it is also given that AC equal to BD, henceforth it is being bisected, no children, henceforth OA equal to OC, OD equal to OB, and all the angles are 90 degree. That is what I have written in my next step. Now I am going to consider triangle AOB and DOC. AOB and DOC. In order to prove opposite sides of the given quadrilateral are equal. So first I know these two sides are equal. That is OA equal to OC. Similar way OB equal to OD. And the angle I can take either as vertical opposite angles or AOB equal to DOC as 90 degree. Hence these two triangles are congruent by SAS congruency. Hence by CPCT I can say AB equal to DC. Similar way I can prove AD equal to BC by taking AOD and BOC triangles. Next by taking AOB and OBC triangles. These two sides are equal and this is the common side. And by CPCT, I can say AB equal to BC. Now, I have proved all the sides are equal. That is AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to DA. Okay, children. Now, what I am going to do means, so what I have explained, I have given here in the notes, children. Kindly copy it down. All the sides are equal. Up to here I have proved. Now what is my next step? I will explain. Now in order to prove angle ADC as 90 degree, first I should prove angle ADC is equal to angle BCD. Hence what I am going to do is here I will take triangle ADC and triangle BCD. As I know the diagonals are equal. Okay, one common side, AC equal to BD, next DC equal to DC, one common pair I got. Already we have proved the sides are equal, hence AD equal to BC. Now by SSS congruence, triangle ADC is congruent to triangle BCD. Now what I am going to do means angle ADC is equal to angle BCD by CPCT I will take children. Now next I am going to add angle ADC plus angle BCD, both are co-interior angles. When I add these two, I should get 180 degrees. As these two angles are equal, I will take 2 times of angle ADC is equal to 180 degree. What I have explained, same I have written here children. Just copy it down. So taking 2 to the other side, it gets cancelled and it becomes 90 degree. One of the interior angles of a quadrilateral is a right angle, hence ABCD is a square. So here is your 6th question children. They have given a parallelogram ABCD. The diagonal AC bisects angle A. Your first question you have to prove this diagonal also bisects this angle C. And you also have to prove ABCD is a rhombus. In order to prove ABCD as a rhombus, you have to prove all sides are equal. They have given ABCD as a parallelogram, children. If I take DC and AB are parallel lines and AC is a transversal. Then I know this is a Z shape, then means alternate angles will be equal. DCA will be equal to CAB. When alternate angles are equal means I can directly say if angle A is been bisected means angle C is also been bisected. ABCD is a parallelogram. DAC equal to angle BCA alternate interior angles. BAC is equal to DCA alternate interior angles. Hence given AC bisects angle A, angle DAC is equal to angle BAC. Angle DAC is equal to angle BAC. Henceforth DAC is equal to angle BAC is equal to angle BCA is equal to angle DCA. Henceforth AC bisects angle C also. This is your first proof. And you have to prove this figure as an rhombus. That means you have to prove all the sides are equal. Hence from 2 and 4 I got angle DAC is equal to angle DCA because BAC is common in the both. Hence I can write DAC is equal to angle DCA. Now DA equal to DC because the we know the statement that side opposite to the equal sides are equal. These two sides are equal. Hence DA equal to DC, DA equal to DC and DA equal to BC. AB equal to CD. That means all the four sides are been equal because these two sides are opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal is one statement. And from here we have got DA equal to DC, side opposite to the equal sides are equal. Hence ABCD is a rhombus. That is your second proof, children. Kindly copy in your notes.